So today we are going to discuss some more mathematical models of linear programming problem, because mathematical modeling of linear programming problem is the first step to its solution, and we shall see variety of problems, different kinds of situations where we shall try to convert the language form of problem into mathematical model. So before this, I shall explain you the basic definitions in linear programming problem. So x1, x2, xn, etc., which satisfy the constraints of linear programming problem, is called the solution. So if we write an objective function and the constraint in equations, then the values of all these x1, x2, xn, which are able to satisfy all the restrictions, all the constraints of linear programming, then these values are known as decision variables. If a variable is not able to satisfy either one or a set of inequations, a set of constraints of linear programming problem, then that decision variable no longer exists. So remember, only those decision variables which are able to satisfy the constraints of linear programming problem are called solutions. So a linear programming has a solution only and only when all the linear inequations, all the constant inequations are satisfied. Then comes the feasible solution. Even though the constant equations might have been satisfied, but if the non-negativity constraints, that is x1 and x2 greater than equal to 0, are not satisfied, I have already told you in my earlier classes that the decision variables cannot be less than 0, cannot be negative, cannot be obtained free of cost from other sources. So, all the decision variables will be either 0 or equal to, either will be 0 or greater than 0. So, non-negativity constraints, that is all decision variables x1, x2, xn have to be greater than equal to 0, and the solution of linear programming problem which satisfies the non-negativity constraints also is called a feasible solution. So there could be a solution you may get a solution where all the restrictions, all the constraints equations are satisfied, but non-negativity constraint is not satisfied. In that case, that will not be considered as a feasible solution of the given set of linear programming problem. So this is why we say a solution is feasible only and when if all the non-negativity constraints are fully satisfied. What is basic solution? If it is said that if there are m simultaneous equations in n unknowns and n is greater than m, means number of unknowns are n, which is more than the simultaneous equations given, then a solution obtained by setting n minus m are called non-basic variables, and remaining m variables are called basic variables. Means we are setting n minus m equations as non-basic variables and remaining m variables as basic variables, then this constitutes a basic solution. And then comes basic residual solution. What does it mean? A solution of linear programming problem which is basic solution of linear programming problem which is feasible also, that is which satisfies the non-negative constraints also, is a called basic feasible solution. Now again there could be two cases. You can get basic feasible solutions as non-degenerate or degenerate. A non-degenerate solution is one in which exactly m positive non-zero basic variables are available, because you have said there n unknowns and m equations. So if there are m positive non-zero basic variables, then it is called a non-degenerate solution. And if one or more basic feasible solutions, basic variables becomes zero, then it becomes a degenerate solution. And if a solution becomes degenerate, then degeneracy has to be removed, then only we can get an optimal solution. So degeneracy is a big cause of concern in all the linear programming problems. So now we have learnt basic solution, feasible solution, basic solution, basic feasible solutions, and degenerate and non-degenerate solutions. So non-degenerate basic feasible solutions can again be of many types. There you can find many non-degenerate basic feasible solutions, and the one which optimizes or maximizes, optimizes means which maximizes or minimizes the objective function of linear programming problem, is called optimal feasible solution. So the optimal feasible solution is one of the many basic feasible solutions, non-degenerate solutions which are available. So our intention in getting a final solution of a linear programming problem is to start from a basic feasible solution and then continually improve it, so that a stage comes when the value of the variables reaches a stage when the value of the objective function gets maximized or minimized, as the case may be, and then it is known as optimal feasible solution. And what is convex set? Convex set is a polygon in which if you choose two points arbitrarily and a straight line segment joining these points lie completely within the polygon, then these extreme points are giving you the basic solutions of linear programming problem. If in a polygon, if you join arbitrarily any two points, these points could be exterior to the polygon or interior to the polygon. Here the condition is that these two points should be such that if you join them, it will be interior to the polygon, and then these two extreme points will give you one basic solution of the linear programming problem. Out of so many basic solutions, we have to find the most suitable solution, that is the maximum which maximizes or minimizes the objective function. So our interest is to find from the convex set all possible, say, basic solutions, and then get the one which maximizes or minimizes our objective function. So now we consider one more example of linear programming model. In this particular example, it is stated that a company produces two kinds of products, product P1 and P2. P is the abbreviated form of the product. So we say P1 is the product 1, P2 is the product 2. For production of both the products, you have to use lathe and milling machine both. The processing time per unit of P1 on lathe 1 is 5 hours, and the processing time per unit of P1 on milling machine is 4 hours. Similarly, the processing time per unit of P2 on lathe is 10 hours, and that on milling machine is 4 hours. These are the resource constraints. Then the plant capacity is also limited. The maximum number of hours available on lathe and milling machine is 60 hours and 40 hours only per week. Profit by selling product P1 and P2 is rupees 6 and rupees 8 per unit. So we have to formulate the given linear programming model and then find out the production volume of each kind of product so that our profit maximized. In this particular case, in this class, we shall first find out the mathematical model, and solution of the problem after the mathematical model is given will be discussed in the subsequent classes. First we shall try to give mathematical model of different kinds of problems. This is called a product mix problem, because there are two kinds of products and profit earned on selling each type of product is different, resource constraints are different. So we have to find a suitable product mix so that the profit of the enterprise is maximized. This is why this is called a product mix problem. So we are going to formulate a mathematical model of a product mix problem. So all the restrictions or all the data given in the above problem have been converted into a matrix form here. So this is product P1, this is product P2, and this is the limit on machine hours. So machine used for both the products P1 and P2 are lathe and milling. So for lathe, for one product is 5 hours per unit. We have written machine hours per unit. So for product P1, lathe is required 5 hours per unit, for product P2, 10 hours per unit, and maximum machine hours is 60 of lathe per week. Similarly, for milling it is 4 and 4, maximum man hours available is 40, profit per unit of by selling product P1 is 6 and that of product P2 is 8, and all the data have been converted here. So we have to find out how much of product P1 and how much quantity of product P2 should be produced so that the profit is maximized. So here we have said that let X1 be the quantity of production volume of product P1 and X2 be the production volume of P2. So if we produce X1 units of product P1, profit earned is 6X1. If we produce X2 unit of product P2, the profit earned is 8X2. So So the total profit is 6x1 plus 8x2, and this is our objective function z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2, and our intent is to maximize the profit. So z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2. Now we write the constraints in equations. What happens? Total machine hours available per week on less machine is 60. If you are producing x1 units of product P1, so we consume 5x1 hours.